Time for you, Oscar.
First of all, congratulations on the win. With all the changes, short notice, new opponent, you really look forward to fighting Virgil. That fight's still there.
I'm not hoping on it. I don't know what his plans are. Let him rest and recover, and you know, wish him all the best in recovery. Health is important. You know, he's only 23 years old, but I'm here. You know, I've proven this week that, firstly, I've proven when I accepted to fight Virgil Ortiz that I fear no one and I'll fight anybody. But not only that, since the pullout, I've proven that I will fight anybody. You've seen seven names have come to me and I said yes, but actually more names have come to my team and they said yes without coming to me. So it's been a very stressful week for me, my team, you know, Lee Eaton, who's out in Dubai. We've been working on three time zones this week. So it's been so stressful.
But here, let's walk to your team really quick.
Okay,
so first of all, he fought tonight, but look at his face. It looks like he hasn't even stepped in the ring yet. What does that say?
This is how I look after every fight.
You want to keep it that way. Now, I just talked to Alexis Rocha.
Yeah.
And he told me he'd love to fight you next. And I asked him, do you want to run up on you? He said, no, we're cool. What do you think?
Yeah, there's no trash talking needed. He's such a respectful guy. Him and his team. Like, I've been really friendly with his team all week. You know, if Golden Boy want to sit down and talk the match room, 100%, I'd love to come back. I'd want to come Vegas, though. Like, that is a bucket list. I'd love to fight in Vegas, but wherever in the States, I feel like I've won a lot of support this week with what I've gone through and how I've handled everything. They said they want to come to England, so it's one of them. whichever, do you know what I mean? So whichever, like, I want big fights, and I've proven that I will fight anybody. So whatever makes sense, whatever's paying the most, let's do it.
Okay, got to ask you this really quick.
Yeah.
Tonight in Dubai, Regis fought.
Yeah.
What do you think if Regis moves up to 47?
Oh, he's a fantastic fighter, isn't he? He's a fantastic fighter, a southpaw. I would love them fights, you know. Like, my name being alongside these big names.
Spence Ugas winner.
Spence. Would I fight?
Yeah,
him? Of course.
You said Spence.
Of course. Like, what do you think? How I've said yes to every opponent this week. So I want the biggest fight possible.
Crawford doesn't have a fight.
Of course. I've got a good WBO ranking. Like, these guys are like the elite of the division. Like, I know that, and I know that
that's where you want to be.
I haven't proven that I am genuine elite world class yet. I had the opportunity this week. But I haven't proven that yet. But 100% I will take that. I will take them fights. I want to fight world-class fighters, because you see McKinson in there with a world-class fighter, it won't be negative, will it? Because out at the fight tonight, it wasn't the best to watch. But out of the two of us, Martin was more negative than I was.
But we have to look at it like this. In 6 months or 1 year, people are going to go look at your boxing record, and all they want to know, do you have a W or an L? They don't. This performance,
yeah,
you pass it. There's a lot happened this week. It's okay.
I don't know what it's like to lose.
22-0, right?
22-0. I've been a pro 7.5 years, 8.5 years. It was very hard for me early on. Over the last 12 months, have been great, great for me. I'm starting to get the credit and the respect I deserve in boxing. So I know there's going to be a lot of people that are going to rate my performance and say, but at the end of the day, I won like I always do.
If you weren't a boxer, what would you be? What athlete? Soccer? Football?
I don't know. Boxing's the only thing I know. Like, boxing is the only thing I know. It's the only thing when I was at school and all my friends were learning different trades and stuff like that, I didn't. I relied on boxing.
100% all in.
Yeah, so all or nothing. So if this boxing game don't work out, I don't know what I would end up being. You know,
a couple more and I'm done. Your favorite fighter growing up?
My favorite fighter growing up, well, my first ever favorite fighter was Prince Nassim. But when I was very young, was Prince Nassim.
Did you emulate him? Did you do the back?
When I was young, I can't do any back flips. But he was my
incredible
favorite when I was really young, when I didn't know much about boxing, like 4 or 5 years old. It was him that I always wanted to be like. You know, so he was my favorite growing up.
Tyson Fury, Dillian Whyte. I'm picking Whyte by knockout. What do you think?
I think he can too. Because he's the banana skin for Fury. You know, he is the banana skin for Fury. He can really whack. And you know, like, and heavyweight boxing, anyone can be vulnerable. Anyone can be vulnerable. And like I said, I believe that he could be that banana skin for Fury. I know that Fury would be the favourite, and I know that rightly so as well. He's a hell of a fighter. One of my favourite fighters, the story and all stuff like that. Like, I love Fury, but I feel like Dillian, there's not many people going to give him a chance, and he can be that banana skin. Anything can happen in heavyweight boxing, like everyone says.
Canelo Bivol, your take?
Canelo.
Why?
Canelo's my favourite fighter in the world today.
Why?
He's my favourite fighter. He just does everything amazing. I don't feel like there's anybody from 160 or 175 that beats him, in all honesty. Pound for pound, number one in my eyes. I don't think that...
So you have him?
Yeah.
Why do you and Adrian Broner have the same nickname?
I was called the problem when I first... Obviously, my dad being my trainer, I was grew up in professional...
Where is he?
Well, my dad is somewhere over there talking, but... I grew up in professional gyms, sparring professional fighters from probably 14 years old. And they used to be like, McKinson's a problem, my style. So I never once wanted to have the same nickname as Adrian Broner. No way, I don't feel like he's the best role model and stuff.
He's one of my favourite people.
He's a character and stuff like that, but I was called the problem before I knew who Adrian Broner was, or as he started coming onto the scene.
Would you like to fight him?
I would love to.
Let's make it in England.
I'll show everyone I'm a problem to people in the ring. He's a problem outside of the ring.
All right, there you have it. Tell everyone where to follow you on social media.
Mikey the Problem on Twitter, Mikey the Problem on Instagram. Follow me, follow my journey, and I'm going to the top, trust me.
There you have it. Thank you so much. Congratulations. Elisa back reporting.